Hey everyone! Exciting times ahead indeed for the PC hardware world, with AMD's Ryzen 7000 series of processors and their accompanying X670E and X670 motherboards having been launched on 27 September 2022, Intel is not resting on its laurels and have just announced full details on their Intel 13th generation Raptor Lake processors and their new Z790 chipset as well. To get in on the excitement of these two tech titans squaring it off, we'll take a look at a motherboard sporting the spanking new Intel Z790 chipset, the ASUS TUF Gaming Z790-PLUS WIFI D4. Let's get started! Now with Intel's 13th generation of Raptor Lake processors and their accompanying chipsets, end users will gain access to PCIe 5.0 support as well, which was already a feature with the 12th generation Alder Lake processors. Now a great feature to have too with the 700 series of chipsets is support for both DDR4 and DDR5 memory, which would definitely be helpful for folks out there who might be holding on to, say, fast DDR4 memory sticks and would like to find a use for them. One thing to note, however, is that Intel has not included additional PCIe 5.0 lanes for the 700 series of chipsets, meaning to say, you'd still only get PCIe 5.0 support for the graphics card and not the M.2 drive slots natively, which, in all honesty, is a bit of a bummer. We'll learn more about the specs of the Z790 chipset as we turn our attention to a board that we have here today, the TUF Gaming Z790 Plus Wi-Fi D4. As a product from the TUF Gaming series, I would say that this board is targeted more at casual gamers, offering a good mix of modern features at a slightly more affordable price point. Now if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product offerings from the PC hardware world. As per the design language of the TUF Gaming series, the Z790 Plus Wi-Fi D4 comes in a box sporting a silver on black color scheme, with touches of yellow thrown in for good measure. As the D4 in the model name implies, this board comes with support for DDR4 memory, not DDR5, which sure is an interesting feature to have given that AMD has totally migrated over to DDR5 with its Ryzen 7000 series of processors. Moving over to the rear, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll run through these specs in detail later in this video. Opening up the box, we see that the TUF Gaming Z790 Plus Wi-Fi D4 comes with a Wi-Fi antenna right here. We'll set aside the board for the moment to see what other accessories ASUS has included with the board. With the board out of the way, first up we get two SATA 3 cables, and this is accompanied by a M.2 drive screw and standoff pack, and two packs of M.2 drive rubber pads that add additional height clearance for single-sided M.2 drives. We also get the motherboard manual and, surprisingly, a DVD driver disc right here, even though optical drives are becoming a thing of the past. On top of these, we also get a quick start guide right here, a certificate of reliability that shows the battery of tests that some of the components of this board have been subjected to, a sheet of TUF Gaming stickers that look pretty nice, and this is rounded off by an ASUS Web Storage promotional leaflet. Onto the board itself, we see that ASUS has gone for a black and grey colour scheme with touches of yellow, which is very much in line with the TUF Gaming brand identity. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design and has large black heat sinks with TUF Gaming motifs all around. As can be seen, hexagonal patterns seem to be the name of the game with this particular TUF Gaming motherboard. In terms of onboard RGB LEDs, the Z790 Plus Wi-Fi D4 has RGB LED accents in these areas of the board and are somewhat subtle, I would say, in terms of their appearance. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and ASUS has included 16+1 power stages. The board comes with a passive heatsink for the Z790 chipset, which is adorned with gamer-like motifs. For M2 drive cooling, ASUS has included M2 drive heatsinks for 3 out of the 4 M2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the TUF Gaming Z790-PLUS WIFI D4 comes with 4 DDR4 slots, not DDR5, with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR4 5333 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design that ASUS calls QDIM. Further down from the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header, and beneath it, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header which supports up to 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses 2 USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for up to 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Near the USB 2.0 headers is a Thunderbolt add-on card header, which is to be used in conjunction with an add-on card that is sold separately by ASUS. The said card adds Thunderbolt 4 and additional DisplayPort connectors for your PC. Finally, an unexpected feature included with the board is a serial port header located right here, which I suppose is a legacy feature that could come in useful, especially in more business-oriented settings. Another useful feature that is included with the board is QLED, which are built-in LEDs right here that can be used to troubleshoot power-on self-test issues. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a single PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot comes with the safe slot feature, which reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards, and also has what ASUS calls Q-Release. Now, Q-Release is a feature that makes removing a graphics card a painless affair, especially from a completed build. Pressing this button here will undo the Q-Release latch to allow the graphics card to be pulled out from the slot with ease. We also do get two PCIe 3.0 X1 slots, a PCIe 4.0 X4 slot, and a full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode. In the storage department, ASUS has included 4 SATA 3 ports, of which 2 of them are in a right-angled configuration and 2 of them in a straight-angled configuration. For M2 slots, it comes with 4 PCIe 4.0 X4 M2 slots, of which the 4th slot here also supports SATA M2 drives. All of these slots come with the Q-Latch feature, which facilitates the toolless installation of your M2 drives. For audio, ASUS has included a higher-end Realtek S1220A audio codec with premium audio capacitors. Wired internet connectivity is powered by Intel's i226V chip, which provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi support is courtesy of Intel's AX201 NGW Wi-Fi 6 part, which also serves up Bluetooth 5.2 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 7 fan headers, which are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and a single 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the TUF Gaming Z790-PLUS WIFI D4 goes for an integrated I/O shield design in black. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector supporting the 4K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports the 4K resolution at 60Hz, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C port, 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port right here, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, as well as your standard audio jack connectors. With that, the ASUS TUF Gaming Z790-PLUS WIFI D4 has all the features that you need to build a modern Intel 13th generation Raptor Lake gaming PC, with features such as PCIe 5.0 support for a graphics card, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, and Wi-Fi 6. This is helped by the fact that this board supports DDR4 memory, which should lower the costs of building a PC with this board. A missed opportunity for the 700 series of chipsets is the lack of native PCIe 5.0 support for M.2 drives, which will likely only come with Intel's next generation of processor offerings. With that, thank you so much for watching, smash the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.